Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm gonna be doing a collaboration video to get you guys all really motivated for spring cleaning. So it has warmed up here in the Midwest, and as soon as the weather starts warming up, I kinda get that itch to clean and just do more of that deep cleaning, spring cleaning type stuff, not just the average, you know, sweeping the floors and scrubbing the toilets, the things I pretty much have to do all day long with four kids coming in and out of the house, but more of the deep clean things where we are really getting the house clean in spots that we don't usually clean throughout the year. So this video is going to be really, really fun because I have teamed up with a few of my friends here on YouTube, and they're also gonna be giving you some spring cleaning tips, and everybody sharing something a little bit different. First up, we have Cami from the blog and channel Tidbits, and she's gonna be showing you what's in her spring cleaning caddy for herself and also for her kids. And then my friend Julie Blanner from the blog julieblanner.com. I have collaborated with her here before on YouTube. She has some really, really awesome videos on organizing and cleaning, and today she's gonna be giving you her spring cleaning checklist. And then also my friend Chloe from Boxwood Avenue, she's gonna be showing you her favorite green cleaning products for spring cleaning and also how she organizes her cleaning cabinet. So I am super excited to do this video with these ladies because they all have such great ideas and we're all sharing something a little bit different. So after you guys watch my video, be sure to go check them out. I have all of them linked down in the description below. I'm gonna be doing a clean with me video here and showing you the few things that I do differently for spring cleaning. One thing I love to do a few times a year is freshening up my mattress. I'm taking all the sheets off the bed and I'm gonna wash everything, including the blankets and the comforter. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm sprinkling baking soda on top of my mattress and I'm gonna let it sit there for about an hour or so. And then I'm going to vacuum it up. And this is really good at eliminating odors and just freshening and cleaning your mattress. Now, if you do this on a day where it's really nice and sunny out, unfortunately today is cloudy and rainy, but if it's sunny, you can also take your mattress outside, obviously put it in a nice clean spot and let the sun hit your mattress. That's also gonna be really good, helping to clean and freshen your mattress. Next up, I headed into the kitchen and I'm doing some things in here that I don't do on a daily or even weekly basis. And that is really scrubbing the kitchen cabinets, the walls, the baseboards, the tables, and the chairs. This is all things that need to be done more often than I even get to it. Now I am using my all-purpose house cleaner here with a microfiber cloth. This is my favorite spray to use for cleaning. It's super easy to make. I will link it here up in the cards and also down in the description below. It works really well, and of course it's all natural, so I love that. So then the kids can even help me clean and I don't have to worry about them breathing in bad chemicals or getting it onto their skin. I have a really big nice bookshelf that you guys have probably seen tons of times, but I film in front of it for most of my videos, and that's because I joke and say this is pretty much the only nice thing in my house where I think it looks really nice. My husband actually built this for me on my birthday a few years ago, and a few times a year I like to take everything off of it and just dust it really well, and also dust everything that is on there and then put it back on just to freshen it up, make it look nice. Now I am using a homemade dusting solution where it is just a quarter of a cup of olive oil and 10 drops of wild orange essential oil, and this works really good for getting the dust off and also leaving a nice shine. Okay, the couches. I have shared my debt-free video here before and I talked a little bit about these couches, so I will link that video if you're interested in watching it. But these couches, I know, are not much. They're very, I think, ugly. They are dirty, they are stained, and we bought them used before we got married, which has been 8 years ago now, and so they really don't look the best, but I do love that the couch cushions all have covers on there that are removable. So I'm taking all of those off. I'm going to wash them in a cold cycle with my all natural laundry soap that I make. And then I'm going to vacuum in and under and around and really just get in there and make sure to get all the crumbs out that are in there, because we do eat on our couches sometimes when we're having, you know, a family movie night or things like that. So I'm gonna just get all of that yucky stuff out of here. And when I put the couch cushions back on after being washed, it really does make a big difference in how it looks. Okay, the next tip that I have for spring cleaning, and something that I love to do, starting in one room at a time, move all the furniture and just sweep and vacuum and mop underneath of the rugs and the couches and the shelves and the beds, all these things, because this is something that we don't do very often, but definitely needs to be done. The next thing for my spring cleaning is doing all the windows and the windowsills. Now again, I'm just using my all-purpose spray here. It works really well at cleaning windows and it leaves no streaks, so I love that. So I'm using my all-purpose spray in a microfiber cloth, and I'm just going to go around the house and spray and do all the windows, wipe out all the windowsills, and just get everything nice and clean. One other thing that I thought of that I did not include in this video, but I thought about later, so I thought I'd add it in, is I really like to use one of those dusters that like go around your fan blade. We used to call it a fanny. I'm sure there's a better name for that, but you can take it and you can kind of go in between all the fan blades to get those dusted. And the one that I always used had a pole that had an extension on there, and then I can go around and do the walls and the ceilings and just kind of dust around the top of the house. And if there's any cobwebs or spider webs, hopefully there's none of that in the house, but if there is, you can go around and kind of get all of that out. So those are my things that I do extra for spring cleaning, and I really get satisfied by doing spring cleaning stuff because it's something that actually lasts a little bit longer. It seems like I can sweep my floor 30 times a day, and somehow every time that I sweep it, I still come up with this huge pile of dust and crumbs, and I don't even know how it all gets there. So these are the types of things I really like to do, because the windows do stay clean for a little while, and the windowsills and the top of the fan and dusting and all that stuff. So this stuff is more satisfying to do. So I hope you guys get some cleaning motivation and some ideas for this while you go around and spring clean your home. Be sure to check out my description box so you can check out my friends' videos and see their ideas, and also I'll have down there the recipes to the different cleaners that I have talked about here today and the different videos that I mentioned. So thank you so much for stopping by. And if you're new here, be sure to hit that subscribe button. I get out new videos every week on essential oil education, natural remedies, and I share lots of different healthy recipes. Thank you so much for stopping by Our Really House.